Welcome to Trionic 7, the YouTube channel for Saab enthusiasts. Today I'm going to show you how to rescue a bricked Saab 9.5 or Saab 9.3 ECU. Here I have a T7 or Trionic 7 ECU module. These are commonly found on most Saab 9.5s, but also some of the Saab 9.3 models. These same instructions will also apply to T5 engine. It's a very similar procedure, just some very minor differences. So every time you try to flash the software in one of these ECUs, there's a small chance that the flashing fails. And if you're unlucky, you might even brick the ECU, so that you will not be able to use CAN bus to flash anymore. Luckily, the Saab engineers have designed a background debugging mode called BDM, which will help you rescue your ECU in case of total CAN bus failure. So to take it apart, I'll use a T10 Torx wrench to open up the four corners here. I think that will be enough. All right, so what I did was to loosen the four screws in the corners, as well as the two screws here on the bottom. Then you just pull everything out. And here we have the PCB. You can really see that there's high quality stuff inside here. Also, since this is an automotive electronics component, they've also coated the PCB with some kind of plastic lacquer or something. It feels sticky to your fingers. Also, if you're watching this on how to rescue your Trionic 5 or T5 ECU, this will obviously look a bit different because it's a different hardware. But what we're actually looking for are these 10 little connectors down at the bottom. You will also find them on your T5 ECU somewhere similar to this. This is where we will attach our BDM connector. We will first need to drill the holes. Some people prefer using a soldering iron and then blowing out the solder, but I found that drilling actually works much faster. And then we connect the little connectors to those holes, and we will end up with a finished BDM connector. Okay, here we go. Time to do some drilling. I put a piece of wood underneath so it doesn't hurt the table. And I'm using a 0.95mm drill bit. I think this should be enough, but I'll report back to you as soon as I can. Okay, you see the first hole has been drilled, and I can say that the 0.95mm drill seems perfect. You will really need to keep a steady hand, use rather high RPM and push very slowly. And the Dremel drill will make quick work out of these holes. Okay, drilling is done. As you can see, it became quite messy here with all the drill shavings. So the next step is to do some cleaning. Okay, I cleaned everything off nicely, and I noticed that this lacquer thing on the PCB really makes the dust stick to it. So be sure to get all the little shavings and all the little dust things away from the PCB, including this little thing here. Go away. I don't want to short-circuiting my PCB. Let's fit the connectors. Like this. And it looks really nice. And the last step will be to solder these connectors here on the back side. Again, remember that the lacquer thing here will make a bit of a mess, but just work cleanly and carefully and you will do a good job. And the soldering is done. No, it's not the best soldering I've ever made, but I checked it under the microscope and everything looks fine. So after following these instructions, you will have a nice BDM connector on your Trionic 7 ECU. And here is how you perform a BDM connection to actually save the ECU. So if you look on the Trionic 7 documentation, you will find the pinouts where you should put plus 12 volts and where you should put the ground. This is very messy, I'm just making a very quick video for you. Then you connect the BDM cable to the newly soldered BDM port to your BDM adapter. I am using John C's Combi adapter. If you want to buy this adapter, it costs around 100 euros. You can check out the links down below in the video description. This Combi adapter is very good because it's very fast and also works with CAN bus flashing, as I showed in a previous video. This adapter you connect with the USB up to your laptop. And on this laptop I'm running BDM tool. With BDM tool you can download and flash new software onto your Bict ECU. You just click right and then select the bin file. Then press enter and it says that the current flash memory will be lost. Do you want to continue? Yes. Now we see down below it says erasing or writing flash. And again, this can be done even if you cannot access the Trinex 7 ECU with Canvas. And when BDM tool goes back to normal, everything is done. And this concludes this video where I've shown you how to recover a dead ECU. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below or follow us on social media. We have Facebook, Google+, Reddit, Twitter, and Instagram. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.